Hello everyone, I'm East and welcome. I'm going to show you guys how to build a crystal fountain with a smoke effect that I love and hopefully you will too. So with that done, let's get straight to it. Okay, for this build, the only things that you're gonna need is a solid block, a stair, two slabs, two different ones that you like. Mostly the one slab must match the solid block and the stair, the other one you can pick. Then a concrete of your choosing and stained glass also of your choosing and paints. But I'm gonna use deep slate, purple and magenta because the contrast between them is just very nice and beautiful and I like it. So let me show you what you're gonna do with all this stuff. And the bone meal and oak leaves and shovel is just there for decoration. I'll show you guys at the end how to use this. Okay. What we do first is we just get a area open, place one block in, just place one block, then you count 1, 2, 3, 4. Place one slab, the same on this side, 1, 2, 3, 4, slab, this side, 1, 2, 3, 4, slab, on this side, 1, 2, 3, 4, slab. Next, you place by them all so that they can be three slabs wide. Next, you place two slabs here, two there, same on the other side. This side and finally this side. Then you'll have this circle formation of a fountain outline that you're gonna have. Next, you'll get your deep slate tile stairs, place them all around the slabs. Okay, with this finished, the next thing you do is break the blocks beneath it. Make sure you break all the blocks. You can make it as deep as you want, but like you guys can see, I'm doing this on a flat world, so I'm just gonna go down to bedrock with this, and I'm gonna show you what to do after it. Okay. Then just break the blocks beneath the stairs so that the stairs and the solid block can match. Just take it also all the way down and start filling it in. Okay, after you have filled in all the sides so it looks the exact same as your stairs, go to the bottom where you want to place your concrete. Just fill this in. Like I said, I'm using purple because the purple contrasts very nice with the dark deep slate. After you fill this in, take your after you guys have filled this in, get your solid block, just place it all the way to the bottom. Break that slab, make it up, then at the bottom you can place stairs around so it looks like if it's getting thicker as it goes down. Just place here a little few on top, then we go back down. If next you take your magenta glass, place it all around the bottom. After it, we take our purple stained glass, fill the top in. And when we are finished with the purple, we go back to magenta and then we fill the last in. And as you can see, it gives a smoke effect, like it's going deep into the void of nothingness. After this, just count the blocks. Let it be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So if you stand, it's just about this high. Next, we take our stairs, place it all around the pillar, the central pillar. Then you take your deep slate tiles, fill in all the sides. Next, just place on top and break this middle one so it looks like there's something going out. Then you'll have this type of shape. After it, we take our purple stained glass, place a few in here, break there, so it looks like this. Next, we take our magenta stained glass, place one, two there, one here, break this one, go down, place another one here, take your purple stained glass again, line it up. Break that one. Then you just have to check that it's lining up with a p with one of the center pieces that you want with. Then you just come down, place another two, break your purple stained glass so they disconnect from each other. So you'll have just this floating panes around your fountain. Next, we come o back to this side. You can mix and match them as you want. You'll see when I'm finished here how it looks. Okay, progress update. This is how it's so far looking. I'm almost finished with all my crystals. Oh, this one is on the wrong side. Let me move them just one block back. Break and break. There we go. Just have to put some stuff still here and this side. Let's continue. Okay, now all the crystals are in place. As you can see, they are floating all around the fountain. So this is how the fountain will look when you are finished. The crystal placements, you can see I just left like one spot in between them so they can just be like a small pane. So it looks like they are floating everywhere and all around about. So it gives a little bit of a magic feel to your fountain. And you can build this in any type of block of your choosing. It's just I like this new deep slate that they bring in. And like I said, the purple just contrast very nice with a deep slate. Now for the finishing touch. As for the last piece of decoration, I'm gonna use the leaves, bone meal, and shovel to give it an overgrown feeling. Just to make it more interesting and more beautiful around the fountain. Just to give it a little bit lively feeling. You'll see now as I begin. So let's jump into this. The shovel I'm gonna use to make pathways around the fountain to give it a walkway for people to walk around the fountain and enjoy the crystal view with the magic all around. Let's begin here at the one corner with the leaves. I'm placing the leaves all around the corners. Just to make it a more bulky, so it's not that as small and circular as it already is. So this is just giving it a more environmental feeling around the fountain to give it more life and beauty all around. Let's do the last piece of leafage. Okay, let's use the shovel to make pathways around the fountain to give a little bit of a walkway. I like to make it too wide because just one pathway doesn't look as nice around the fountain. As you can see how it looked, so we're sticking with too wide, and I'm gonna do it all around the fountain. As you can see, the pathway is connected, is half in like a oval circle shape around the fountain, just to give it a more natural feeling. So you can do it like this, or you can go full on circle mode. Now we're gonna use the bone meal to bring more life to the fountain, more nature energy. You can say magic. Let's go all around. Okay, I'm just gonna use some of the leaves, or well, not leaves, grass and ferns to make it double, or you can see big, just to make it a better shape all around the fountain. And this looks quite nice in my opinion. I hope you guys enjoy this, how it looks. This is how the fountain now looks at the end. It can fit into a nice medieval build or dark theme build that you have, and it looks quite good. Oh, I like it, I love it. I hope you guys love it. So I will be checking you guys very soon again. Goodbye and enjoy your day.